big sheet of blue rubber is made into the bottoms of the sneakers.
You mean that thing's all rubber?
It's all rubber. It's going to the machine. And this machine forms the sheet into long, thick rubber strips.
Hi, Jackie.
Hi, Daddy.
How are you?
I'm good.
Excellent. Hey, John?
They look like thick blue ribbons. They do. Up, getting cooled by some water. Oh, so they were hot.
Yeah, John, I left a napkin. Right. Hit, this is...
Next,
this is Carol's, strip, like, best friend, Larry, man.
Shorter strips.
I will look up the bar today, man. That's who she's the hangout
okay,
with the girl,
right.
Cindy, so... He just said that he would love to go down if she went down to support her, you know what I mean?
All right.
So I'm sure she'd be happy to hear from
just
me.
Just
so,
wait.
Yeah, that's okay. All. Thanks, man. Yeah.
The strips of rubber are put into these molds and melted. That's what this man's doing. And he has to wait for a few moments. They look very hot, but they're hot. You can see the rubber has melted just the right amount, and it forms the bottom part of the sneaker. Does look like the bottom of a sneaker there. Now what happens? Well, next is trimming. This machine is doing that. It's trimming off the extra rubber from the edges. And what are those men doing? Well, these men look at each one and trim off any more rubber that the machine may have missed.
Uh-huh. That's the bottom of the shoe.
That's the bottom of the shoe.
You mean where you put your foot?
That's right. This machine cuts out many layers of insoles at one time.
Just look how many it can do.
And these men check each insole to make sure it's just right.
Now, what's this?
This is the top part of a sneaker being cut out of canvas. Now, this machine works something like a cookie cutter. Presses down and cuts the canvas. It cuts it in just the right size and shape for the top of the sneaker.
That's fun to see that.
Now watch, he'll bring out some top parts. There you go.
Those are going to be top parts of the shoe.
That's right.
What's this woman doing?
She's putting in the holes for the shoelaces.
How fast that machine works.
This woman sews all of the canvas top parts together.
I'm not sure that I understand.
Yes, it does. Beginning to look like a snake.
Oh, look how fast she works. It must take a lot of practice to do that job.
Sure does. Sneakers are being formed.
Oh, now that's beginning to look like one.
Well, last, it's time to put all the parts together. First, the top part is glued to the insole. See, there goes the glue. On the conveyor belt, it's on its way. Here comes another. You'll see it again. Way. Now the sneaker is dipped in some more glue.
Oh, I thought that was the white trim that goes around the outside.
It looks like the trim, but really, it's glue to hold the trim on the sneaker.
Uh-huh.
And when the glue has dried just the right amount, this woman has the first layer of rubber trim around the bottom of the shoe. You see there? Mm-hmm. She's doing it now.
She really works carefully.
She does.
Thanks. word Spanish. Recognize that? Parties has on the bottom there? The soul. The soul. And the machine presses them together. Now it's all glued together. But the sneaker needs to have one more rubber strip put around the outside, and then it will be finished. That lady works carefully, too. I never knew it took so many people and so many machines to make a pair of sneakers. It's really interesting, Mr. McPhail. You know me, I like finding out about all kinds of things. And these people are putting in the shoelaces. This woman does one last check to be sure they're just right. She looks them over. And this woman puts the sneakers into boxes. And then they're ready to be sent off to stores for people to buy them and to wear them.